I'm very excited because we are going to talk The Bachelor. Hey, listen, you don't let us ever talk about it, Sky.
Yeah.
You're really mean. We want to talk about it every Tuesday.
Well, I've been watching this show. I don't know who these
fucking
people are.
That's your fault. That's your fault.
Oh, my God.
But there's something that happens every episode that we could do an entire show on.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Easily. But this one is trending. Yeah. So that is why we're going to talk about The Bachelorette last night and jerking off.
We ain't done yet. It's time for the P1 Podcast.
Fun's not over yet.
Completely uncensored and unfiltered, except for that part.
Looking for the after party with no end.
The show's after show starts now.
I'm just going to say it. Katie is the greatest bachelorette of all time.
That's so fucking stupid.
She's so not.
I love her to death.
She's
nothing
very nerdy.
Nothing's her problem.
You can tell
nerdy at all.
She's basic.
She's basic.
Oh, basic.
She can't be sexy. She's very uncomfortable being sexy.
Oh, no.
Like Tayshia can be sexy.
Okay.
Hot.
All right.
Even Caitlyn, who I can't stand.
Don't know who these people are, but okay.
Love Katie. Love
But Katie, when she walks in, like, trying to be hot, it's just like, no.
And I'm like, yes, please.
No.
Oh, you are not.
No, I'm like,
you are
yes,
not.
Please.
Oh, wow.
Wishing I was one of the guys.
Oh, you are.
I don't think that she's ugly.
Oh, man.
I don't think.
She's great.
She's great.
She's just whatever.
And her thing coming into the season.
Don't say it.
Don't
you fucking say it.
Huh. What?
Is sex positive.
What does that even fucking mean, dude?
I don't know.
Does that
that's
mean she has
so
an STD?
Stupid.
No, Sky. No,
that's
Sky.
I don't know
no,
what that
Sky.
Means. I've never heard
no,
that
Sky.
Term.
Well, let me explain something to you, lady,
okay.
Because I feel like you need a little bit of this in your life.
I'm not sex positive.
You're not.
Okay.
You're not. You have shame when it comes to sex. You're embarrassed about sex.
Oh, this
you don't
is true.
Talk about sex.
I don't want to be thought
and
of a
Katie's,
whore.
Exactly.
Yeah,
and Katie's
yeah.
the opposite. She's like,
she
listen, we
to
need
whore?
To be able to talk about things. We need to be open about our sexuality. Why can guys talk about sex openly, but women not be able to talk
basically
about it
basically the
openly?
Way I am, and I've never bragged
very,
about being sex positive.
But you are. You
so
are.
So should I have come on this show day one and been like, I am sex positive.
I would have been like, get out.
Thank you. And I would
get out.
I would have shoved a dildo in your ass.
Wait a minute.
Wait, is that
yeah,
what happens
lady.
When you're sex positive?
Yeah,
I don't know if I like that.
If you want it,
like,
if you want it,
I don't.
Yes.
I don't want it.
It's just
because
so
you're not sex positive.
Oh, wait.
She seems like the chick in high school who's like using sex to try to be cool.
Yes.
That's what it seems like to me.
Anyway.
Don't roll your eyes.
Oh.
There's going to be a day when he says, I was doing a bit, you guys were right.
Well, 100%.
There's
going to
be a fucking 100%. Day.
Because they do
gonna
have this fight off the air about if Katie is good or not.
I love her.
You love her.
I love her.
They
I think
do
she's
not
great.
Love her.
I think she's empowered. I think
the only person more annoyed by this than me and Emily is my fiance, Haley.
Oh, really?
She cannot believe that Eddie believes
she's part of the Don't Get It crew.
Oh, my God.
But I feel like
maybe
Haley.
The captain. Maybe the captain.
But I feel like Haley actually is a sex positive
she is.
Person.
She's very sex positive.
Yeah, but she would never say such a stupid term that isn't a real thing.
Wow.
That she made up for a television show.
She's part of the Don't Get It crew.
Oh, my God.
Okay.
So
okay.
If you are being sex positive
oh,
and, that's your, and that's
that.
Your motto.
Right?
May I? Finish my
story. What are you, Eddie? Greg Popovich now yelling at us.
Well, if I'm dealing with the idiot reporter
okay.
over here.
Oh, excuse me.
Idiot reporters, by the way.
If your whole motto is that you're sex positive.
Okay.
And then in last night's episode,
what?
You declare, I'm going to do a little contest with the men who are vying for her love. And the contest is going to be that you can no longer pleasure yourself, a.k.a. masturbate. For as long as you can hold out. And that's going to be a fun little contest we're
oh
going to do.
God.
And then people got confused, especially online,
yeah.
of if you're sex positive, then why are you telling people to not have sex with themselves? Like, it kind of doesn't make any
you're
sense.
You're, like, shaming them having sex with themselves in a way. Like, the goal
well,
is to
and,
not, right?
And there was a point.
Sort of.
Yeah, and there was a point, too, where she's talking to a guy. And this,
are you talking about Blake?
This fucking moron.
Damn.
This fucking moron.
What's
the,
up
two
with Blake?
Of, the two of
Blake's
us. These
win.
Were the
Blake's
two,
oh,
these
Blake's
were the two
oh.
losers in high school who couldn't get laid
really?
At all.
You would know about that.
So they're trying to be so fucking cool by talking about sex.
Oh.
And he says, yeah, I haven't, you know, pet the one-eyed snake yet. And she goes, I'm kind of offended by that.
Wait,
it was
she's
so,
offended by what?
Because, like, she should be turning them on so much.
Oh, so he should want.
So he should want a jerk off.
And it should be so tough.
It was
the
most cringe conversation I fucking have ever heard.
I really enjoyed it.
No, you did it.
You're such a dick.
You wished you were Blake?
I'd give anything.
Oh, you'd give anything.
This guy's
Blake.
Been in love with 3 women in 2 seasons.
Oh, really?
Yes.
It's like he needed a year and a half.
Yeah.
Like a year and a half.
Listen, he finally found the one. I'm so happy for him. I hope the 2 make it. But anyway, people were upset and saying, listen, if you're going to claim you're sex positive,
right,
why are you telling people to not basically be the same?
Right.
Be sex positive with their own bodies. First of all, I thought, why do you care what's happening on The Bachelor so much that you're making this a trend?
Like, who fucking cares?
Like,
and
you're that deep into this?
Dude, it was like number
like
2
show.
Trending.
A lot.
We like the show a lot. I talk about it. I love commenting. I love texting my 2 girlfriends, Emily, and my best friend's wife, Jenna, about the show.
It's a massive comment.
It's great.
Katie's jacket last night, by the way.
That was the ugliest fucking jacket I've ever
seen.
I loved your blazer.
No,
it was a sparkly blazer dress.
Sky, it was so ugly.
It's beautiful.
I love the show, but I would not go on the Bachelor forums and Twitter and knock the show for this.
You just read them. Yeah.
Do
yeah. You? Yes, he does.
Oh,
yes,
funny.
He does.
Shut up. They're so funny.
Yes, he does.
He really does.
A million
the memes
percent.
Are funny.
Yeah, he got caught, Emily, when you weren't in here in commercial break because he asked you to leave because he wanted to tell Eddie something that was behind the
really,
scenes.
This is what we're doing.
Oh, that's a spoiler from last night.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
I go, how
this
did you know that
doing.
Information?
And then as soon as Eddie goes, how do you know that? You see Thor get real quiet.
Yeah. He's on Bachelor Forums.
No.
Yes,
it was on my search Instagram. And the Bachelor, it's
full
a Bachelor rumor Instagram account called Bitchlorette.
That's so much worse. That is so much worse, dude.
So, I don't know about you guys. But immediately when this whole contest thing got brought up, I went, where are they beating off? I mean, the Bachelor
that's
house.
Like, don't they like share rooms and like bathrooms?
Yes. Yeah. And they kept bringing up, who's taking long showers? And I'm like, really? You're jerking off in the Bachelor house?
In a public shower?
With about 7 different guys in your room? Like, that's weird.
That's what I first, when I thought about it, I was like, wanted to ask you guys what guys do. Like, is that normal? Like, do you guys do that? Like, in the shower all the time? Is that like where?
If it's a circle jerk, yes.
Is that the go-to? Wait,
what? I can't jerk in the shower. I can't jerk off unless I'm watching porn. That's where I'm at in my life.
Oh, that's so sad.
It's hard. I've been watching porn since I was like 12 years old.
Yeah,
so
that's a problem.
I mean, I don't know if I'm a loser. I don't know.
I've been in situations where I've gone like a stretch, like if I'm on a vacation and I need to get away from the family or something like that, where I'm in the shower, you know, you're soaping up and you kind of, you know, I'm spending a little extra time down there.
Oh.
And I go, okay, let's see what happens. And you give it a shot. And, you know, most of the time you can figure it out in the shower. Porn is definitely helpful, but if need be and it's been a minute, I can.
Yeah, if it's been a minute, but if like I jerked off a couple days ago, I'm not going to just rub one out in the shower without a porn. I'll ruin it.
The thing about it is like it's not the sexiest environment. I'm hanging out with a bunch of dudes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's another
and
great
one
point.
Girl, mm-hmm. One girl.
One chick who's not that hot.
Who's beautiful.
Okay.
It's not that hot. There's, what is there, 12 guys left, 10 guys left?
Something like that.
I guarantee 4 are probably actually into her.
Really?
Come on.
I think so, too.
She's so basic.
So, question.
We've moved on now, a-hole.
Yeah, we're not talking
about Katie anymore.
Well, my point is, if they're not that into her, they're not going to be jerking off nonstop.
But why? That's the only thing you would jerk off about is Katie? Of course
she's
not.
She's there.
I know, but you're like when you jerk off, I'm sure you always
I only think about Haley.
Yeah.
I only think about Haley. I only think about her.
Why are you looking at porn?
You picture her on all
the
porn
noises.
Women.
I actually put the screen down.
I put the screen down.
I need the moaning.
Oh, okay.
I need the moaning. And a photo of Haley.
Okay. That makes sense. That makes sense.
Wow. Now I'm weirded out too by the thought of guys masturbating when all these guys are sharing a house. Like you said, I would feel that's not the sexiest sexiest environment. So, like, say, because early in planning Thor's bachelor party, you guys were talking about all sharing this massive house, right?
Yeah.
So it would kind of, in my mind, be similar to the bachelor house, right? It's this massive luxury house with nice bathrooms and, you know,
hot guys.
Yeah. A bunch of hot guys running around partying.
Yeah, yeah. Just like my bachelor party. Yeah. Bunch of hot guys.
Same.
So would it be weird to you guys if you found out one of the dudes masturbated in the house?
Like Dario.
Dario.
Dario
would.
He's asexual.
That's a good point.
I don't even know if he has a penis.
Yeah, that's weird.
So,
it's super weird.
So I doubt it.
To clarify, I do.
Okay.
Yes, okay. Penis.
Had no clue.
I've heard it's a nice one. So.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
We've heard that.
From who?
People who've seen it.
Okay.
If a guy, we're going to be, my bachelor party's 3 days. If you can't go 3 days without jerking off in a house of dudes.
Doug is jerking off in the other room.
That's a little fucking weird, dude.
That's weird.
Like, if I can't go 3 days without rubbing one out with 12 dudes around.
I wouldn't go to dinner with Doug. If I found out he was jerking off in the other room.
You wouldn't?
And we're like, oh, we're going to dinner tonight. I'd be like, I'm good.
Yeah. Sorry,
oh, really?
Doug.
Yeah. No. What about in the shower?
Are you probably using the same shower?
Dude. I'll say with the bachelor.
You're a lunatic if you can't go 3 days without jerking
really?
Off.
Really?
Yes.
Listen, I like to pleasure myself, okay? Is that so crazy to say?
It's weird when you say it in a sentence. Okay.
But I can hang. Like, I was in Palm Springs for a week. I didn't touch myself the entire time.
Congrats. Really?
No.
Yeah.
Like, that's weird. My aunt and uncle are in the next room.
Yeah, that's
my
really
kids
odd.
Are there. It's fucking, it's the most unsexy place ever.
Yeah. I can go a few days without rubbing one out.
I didn't die. I know that sometimes, you know, us guys will, you know, like your husband, Sky, will probably tell you he'd die.
Well, seriously, I'm now thinking, what is the longest he's gone without jerking off? Like, could he go 3 days without jerking off?
Now, you guys were on vacation together. You guys were up, you know, in the Bay Area. Uh-huh.
Right.
Did you have any relations at all up there?
No.
Do you think he was able to pleasure himself at any point?
I don't know. Guy spends a lot of time in the shower, in the bathroom. So,
I mean, if he can't go a couple days without rubbing one out,
like,
he
honestly
needs serious therapy.
Are you going to ask me?
I know. I don't want to have that conversation.
Or he's got a weird addiction.
I think that's more of
a weird addiction. I have faith in him that he can go a few days without rubbing one out.
You know what about the boo that I can say? Very sex positive.
Very sex positive.
Shut up with that word!
Very sex positive.
Yes, too sex positive.